Can you even believe that it's been 3 full months with Animal Crossing New Horizons already? It's been 3 months. That's 3 months of duplicate DIYs, 3 months of Mystery Island Villager excitement, 3 months of that's okay, because this is a seaplane. What a trip it's been, everybody. I think I can safely say that Animal Crossing has undeniably changed my life. So here is my tribute. What's up, guys and girls? It's Zach from Switch Force, and I'm in my feelings today because this game has honestly meant so much to me the past 90 days. And so have all of you. The community we've built, the videos, the streams, the Discord server, it's all positive, all love, all fun. And that to me is truly remarkable. I don't know how we got so lucky. But let me take you back a bit, because believe it or not, I thought I was going to hate ACNH. It's really true, because I get bored easily, I don't like repetitive tasks, I don't like games without defined purpose. But how wrong I was. If you guys have had fun with Animal Crossing the last 3 months, please hit that like button to let me know. And tell me about your Animal Crossing journey in the comments down below. Here's mine. The lead up to Animal Crossing was really tricky for me. My best friend and co-host had been gone from the channel for nearly 9 months. And my parents have been going through a really messy divorce, and even at 30, that's been really tough to be a part of. And honestly, it felt like the whole channel was falling apart. Nintendo didn't have much on the horizon, nothing I was really excited for. The pandemic had started, everybody was locked inside, and truthfully, I really considered skipping AC. I had an event scheduled with my youngest brother for March 20th. That's launch day, March 20th. And I was totally ready to just miss the entire game. But that event got canceled because of quarantine, and so I said, okay, let's give this a legit shot. Let's see what happens. I picked up the game, I turned on my Switch, I said, what the heck? What do we have to lose? Lose? Are you kidding me? Animal Crossing saved the channel and created hope and happiness for all of us. Snooty has to go. She has to. It's not a matter of if, but when.
I'm so sick of Snooty! Get her off this island!
You can't get rid of me that easily. This is my island.
I truthfully cannot believe how nice and friendly everybody has been. The world around us is falling apart, but the community, at least here, defies the norm. You're all so supportive, so helpful, so kind, so fun. I mean, I look at our Switch Strong server and I say, holy freaking crap, how did we create this? That server was actually an idea from my brother Jake, who at one point was a host on this channel. He said, why not use your positivity to help create that for others? And I instantly knew it was a project I had to take on. And I'm so glad I did. Everybody out there trading villagers, donating items, organizing events, cheering others on, it blows my mind. And I'm so proud of us. I'm so proud of what we've created. And I'm so proud of the game. It has been so much fun. I love hunting down all the goofy animal villagers. I love collecting cool items and cool outfits and downloading all those sweet custom hats. I love visiting you guys, checking out your creations, your islands that make my jaw drop. I love slowly but surely improving Crummy Peach Reef and making it into something that is cutely bad, as I like to say. I love patiently waiting for Brewster. Okay, maybe I don't love that, but I do enjoy that I'm so excited for updates. I'm so invested in every little twist and turn that Nintendo brings to this game. There hasn't been much to look forward to lately in the world, but we're all so incredibly pumped for a virtual pigeon and his virtual coffee shop. How cool is that? Oh my gosh, do you guys hear that? Oh my gosh. Do you guys hear that? Are you coming? Is that you? Brewster, oh my gosh. Brewster, land here, Peach Reef, please. I've been waiting for you so long. I got your mug, I got your t-shirt, I got the hype. Follow that bird. I mean, it's no secret that Animal Crossing arrived at the perfect time. And I know in a more normal world, a more normal year, I probably wouldn't have gotten so hooked. But that's okay, because most things happen for a reason. And I know that this game has saved so many people's sanity, spirits, and smiles. And we're in an era where we need happiness. We need lighthearted fun. We need a reminder that things will be okay. And we need to poke fun at Tom Nook's greed. We need to laugh at Isabel being locked inside. We need to get so pumped when our friend finds Judy and when the new fish of the month arrive. Video games have always been an escape. But what I love about this one is that it's been an escape with millions of others along for the ride. AC is not the isolated experience many video games are and can be. It's collaborative, cooperative, collective, and sharing my finds with you, learning new tips from you, and getting so hyped for events and updates alongside you has been incredible. If I think back to my favorite moments so far, it's not winning the game. I mean, that doesn't even really exist here. No, it's touring incredible five-star islands that I know I could never create. It's goofing on Zipper for filling every single pond and river with his dang eggs. It's wearing the Switch Force hoodie and the Bowser hat, the K. Rule hat and the acid wash jeans. It's racing for Raymond and being totally hypnotized by Crunchy Island's insane amount of gold panels. It's drawing the absolute worst versions of characters on your bulletin boards while pretending like I'm some fancy artist. It's the messages you all send, thanking me for my videos, my time, my positivity. It's meeting incredible people and sharing simple moments. And all of that exists because of this game, this little island getaway package.
If I look like I'm tired, it's because I am tired, because out of nowhere, Animal Crossing has dug its hooks into me, and I don't think it's letting go.
March 20th, 2020, I really needed an island getaway package. And I had zero clue if Animal Crossing New Horizons would help or solve anything. I didn't think I'd even like the game. I was sitting in a bummer of a spot mentally, and there was a chance that none of this worked out. But I gotta acknowledge myself real quick for maintaining the positivity, the drive, and the determination necessary to produce great content, fun content, and not let my circumstances define my mood or my attitude. I've always stood for positivity, compassion, being the best you that you can be, and hopefully you guys have seen that over the last 3.5 years of Switch Force. AC has shown us that there is still good out there. There is still fun, teamwork, joy to be had. It may sound kind of silly to attribute so many meaningful concepts to a cast of quirky, cuddly animal characters and really subpar terraforming controls, but you all know it's so true. What a wild 3 months it has been. I don't think any of you wish for these 3 months to ever happen again, but I'm so glad and grateful that we got this game. It has been a brilliant journey, and we've done it together. And it's far from over, because Brewster, diving, holidays, cabin, who knows what else? Even as some of the routine of AC starts to wear a little thin, we know that Nintendo is just about ready to inject New Horizons with some new fun. And we're all gonna be there, together. Because this game has been there for us. It's been there for me, and you have been there for me. And just like in the TV show Lost, one of my all-time favorites, our islands mean far more than just an island. It's been a paradise in a time where paradise is nowhere to be found. Thank you so much for all your support these past 3 months. It really blows me away, and I could not do this without all of you. I'm working my butt off to do you proud, make awesome videos, and I'll continue to do so with Animal Crossing and hopefully some new games that come out later on in the year, if they come out. I mean, we got Paper Mario, a few other things to really look forward to. Gabe is back. I moved back home. I'm feeling really hopeful and happy. I know it's been so rough for so many of you out there, and I'm deeply sorry for anyone that has been so affected during this time. But I hope that my videos, our Animal Crossing journey together, all of it, the Discord server, the friendship, I hope it's made even a little difference in your days, your weeks, your months. Because to me, that's the real success. Views and dollars are really cool. But if I can bring a few smiles, brighten a few of your days, then Switch Force is doing exactly what I've always wanted it to do. And Animal Crossing is a big part of that. So thank you, Nintendo. Thank you, Animal Crossing. And thank you, guys and girls, once again. You're truly remarkable people. And I'm still floored that we have created a fun, safe, not like anything else space on the internet here on Switch Force, there on Switch Strong, together. It's when I sit back and I think, I just go, wow. We're a cool group. We're a really cool group, and I'm really, really grateful. So let's keep it up. Thank you all so much. I appreciate you being there. And like I said, it's been a wild, tricky, emotional time. And I know it has been for a lot of people. And I'm really grateful and lucky and proud. And I think the future is really bright. So hit that like button if you've enjoyed this journey with me. Feel free to share any part of your story in the comments down below. Have a fantastic day. Stay safe and stay healthy. Stay smart out there. And until next time, what a wonderful, wild, irreplaceable, and unrepeatable 3 months it has been. Switch Force, out.